Today we are tackling something super practical, calculating running totals for units that were made without defects. We'll try out some new techniques that might become your go-to tools. Let's dive in. First, let's break this down. A running total keeps track of cumulative values as you go through your data. But here is the twist. We are only counting units where defects are zero, because quality matters. So let's roll up our sleeves and create a formula that is both efficient and elegant. First up, we need a custom column where our magic will happen. Let's name it running totals. But how do we calculate the total so far for each row? Here is the plan. We'll use row numbers to track how far down we've gone in the table. Then we'll filter out rows with defects along the way. Finally, we'll sum up only the good unit. We need row numbers to define our starting point. Sure, we could use an index column. It's a great option. But here is why I like the table position of function. It lets us do everything in one formula. Power query is zero-based, meaning the first row starts at zero, so we need to add plus one. Don't worry, it's straightforward. Next, let's filter our table to include only the rows from the beginning up to the current position. For that, we will use table first n function. The first argument is our table source, and the second argument is the row position we calculated earlier. Now we've got only the rows that come before and including our current one. Pretty neat, huh? Here is where it gets a bit more interesting. To focus only on rows where defects are zero, we'll use the table last n function. This filters down our running list even further. At this point, we've filtered the data, so we are only looking at rows up to the current one, with no defects. We are almost there. Now let's pull out the units made column and calculate the total. Power Query's list sum function is perfect for this. And just like that, we've got our running total for defect-free units. But let's handle one small detail. Sometimes you might end up with null values. Power Query's way of saying there is nothing here. Instead, we can fix this elegantly with the double question mark operator. The double question mark means if this is null, then use something else. So if we get a null total, we'll replace it with zero. And there you have it, a powerful, elegant formula to calculate running totals with defect-free units. Until next time, see ya!